as you all are aware, that sea buckthorn, again, it's a plant which is, I should say, it's also native to India also, because the center of origin is also shared by India also for this plant, if I am correct. So I have seen this plant very closely. I know when I was a scientist at Himachal Pradesh Agriculture University, Palampur, and I was posted at Spiti Valley Regional Research Center. So I got the chance to have some collections. We made some collections, and we maintained them in the field gene bank. And then several collections were also made, and I could understand the importance of this crop, and I have very closely seen in the cold desert system. So here, cold desert region is a very unique area. And when I was there, I remember at that time, we were really astonished to see that such areas are also prevailing in my country. So really, that's in real sense, that's a Himalayan region, we call it. So here, this cold desert region is the home for number of the endemic species of this sea buckthorn, and they provide the considerable scope for area specific comparative advantages which are prevailing here. But the point which I would like to mention here, that here a lot of collections are available, but we need to see that how best we can screen them. And even I remember when I got the chance to have an interaction with a few of our scientist colleagues, some of the Russian varieties have also been introduced, and those Russian varieties have also been compared. And then as Dr. Brahm Singh also mentioned in his presentation, that here the varieties are thorny, the collections are wild in nature, and how we can best utilize and convert this weed to wealth. That's a very important point which you mentioned. But we need to see that vast natural growth which you mentioned, that that is required to be converted into orchard. But I am really astonished, but we would like to learn more details from you, that how these natural vegetations could be converted into the orchards. Because Russia and many other countries like China and others, they are having a planned cultivation. So we need to first promote its planned plantations for sea buckthorn, because mostly it is happening in the forestry areas, where even farmers sometimes they get a kind of problem in collection of the berries. So some kind of policy decision is required to be taken, but we need to abide by the rules, because forestry system again has its own rule. So we need to follow that. But if we can introduce a planned system of the planned system plantation, if we can do just like China and Russia people, they are doing it. Because as I have come to know, that local varieties, only 2 to 3 kg of the fruits could be picked, but in Russian varieties, 15 kg fruit could be picked. So here, 100 gram weight, 100 fruits, if we see, our berries are very small in nature, only 15 grams that weight will be there for 100 berries. 70 gram weight is for Russian varieties and others. We need to see that if we can select some varieties with a bigger fruit stock. I remember at that time we had a selection criteria which we tried to do that. But I could not contribute much at that time. Only some collections were maintained, and some evaluation was done at own farm evaluation was done in different areas, and we tagged those plants. And harvesting is really difficult in case of our wild relatives. So if we see, I think one person, he can collect only little collection could be done, only 25 kg of the berries could be collected by one person. But here, in case of Russian varieties, 150 kg harvesting could be done. I'm just telling these all things about the varieties where plant cultivation is required to be done. So our germplasm also has its value, because a lot of nutritional importances and values are existing into it. And about 3000 metric ton of I should say pulp, that we are importing from several other places, from Mongolia as well as from Russia. But we need to see that how we can become Atmanirbhar Bharat, how we can stop this pulp import. But we need to increase our own capacity for that point of view. So here, I remember when I was horticulture commissioner earlier, now again, the charge has been very recently given to me again. So at that time, the issue was raised, and one Leh Ladakh, that Grover Association, as well as some hill, Leh Ladakh Council is there. They people approached us that sea buckthorn is one of the very important plant. So I was under, I was very well aware about this plant. We immediately accepted it. And though little confusions were there at that time, I told them, again, a kind of policy hurdle will be there because it's a medicinal plant. It comes in the category of medicinal plants. And National Medicinal Plant Board is having the name of this crop in their list. So we have a kind of division that medicinal plants will be dealt by the National Medicinal Plant Board. And here, horticulture crops, particularly aromatics, will be dealt by the Ministry of Agriculture. So this is a kind of division which I am just mentioning. So some kind of policy interventions were needed, and we were unable to promote this crop because it was not in the list of horticulture mission. Then we took a decision and we included this crop. This policy decision was taken, and in the National Horticulture Mission, this crop was included. Horticulture Mission for Northeastern Hills. This is the program through which now we are promoting, and now it is in the list of horticulture crops. And we then we deliberated that how we can further promote this crop. So there are several components which are required to be put into, either it is a high tech nursery, some kind of nursery should nursery concept is required to be taken because it can be vegetatively propagated very easily. Then another point which relates to harvesting with the machine harvesting, as Dr. Brahm Singh also mentioned, that there is a problem in harvesting of the berries from these thorny plants. But if we have some kind of machine which could be devised, then I think the process will become very easy. Then further, I mean, forward linkage, backward linkage, both are required to be addressed together. So that's why this, I mean, in some cases, this flash freezer technology, freeze drying technology, demonstration plots, then processing units, these all were made part of that program. And these all components were included into it. And this was the big policy decision I'm sharing with you, which Government of India took. And we included it in the Horticulture Mission for Northeastern and Northeastern and hilly regions, Himalayan region, I should say the word. So here, as per the figures which were given by DRDO, I think about 11,500 hectare area of land is under natural sea buckthorn plantations in Ladakh, exclusively under this crop. This is existing. But the decision which we took at that time, that opened the ways for further its promotion in the area. And now some kind of mapping has been done. And here another project has also been given to, I should say, in the Leh Ladakh region of JNK related to value chain analysis. So I got the value chain analysis done through one of the institute. We have directorate of areca nut and spices in Kerala. So we gave this assignment to them, and then they submitted a report. And on the basis of that report, we came across that we need to have a kind of end-to-end connectivity promote it. So accordingly, some decisions were taken, and the package of production technology, which was designed by Dihar Institute, as well as we also borrowed some of the information from other countries, and then we made the cost norms and guidelines have been worked out, and those guidelines are now being pursued. So this is a kind of initiative which I mentioned you the background, because many of us, they may not be knowing it, but we need to really see and address the very important issues. One is germplasm collection. A lot of germplasm collection has been done, as Dr. Brahm Singh also mentioned about some of the center at Kukumseri, and then our center at Tabo, and then one more center is at Spiti Valley, then Ladakh, our defense research center. They have also done a good job. I think that was the first institute where they put all their efforts for promotion of this crop and further conducting the research. So then center of excellence, this is another decision which we took. And that center of excellence has been established now. And that center of excellence is now functioning at fruit plant nursery Nimu, Leh. In Leh, it is functioning. So this center of excellence will address all the issues, right from planting material till I should say post-harvest management. And further value addition part is also required to be looked into. But my concern now is that why it is still in a forestry plant? So it should have got the status of a plant cultivation. I hope through the efforts of Horticulture Mission for Northeastern Region and Hills, I think now plant cultivation will definitely happen. And we really need to have guidance from such august gathering where scientists and experts, they are sitting together and they need to further chalk out the strategy. They need to guide further that how we need to promote this crop. Because I know the work was started long back, but till today, because long back in the year early 90s, it was started. But till today, we do not have a kind of perfection. And the volume which we expected is not coming. That's why still to meet the requirement of the country, we are still importing it. So here from the community lands to plant cultivation, that is required to be taken care of. Another thing, we need to now see that lot of health compounds are available into it. On the basis of those health compounds, if we can do a kind of screening and further evaluation is required to be done, and then only those varieties are required to be promoted. So the HAR center, they have already done a good job, but so far we have not come out with a released variety. I know why we have not come out of with a released variety, because we did not follow the multi-location testing of those varieties. But we need to see that if we can take out the cuttings and further, if we can make them available, and if all these three to four states, if they join hands, some kind of multi-location testing could be done, and location-specific as well as situation-specific varieties could be identified, as Dr. Brahm Singh also mentioned in his presentation, that we need to identify location and situation-specific varieties for their suitability to that particular agroclimatic zone. So now country is thinking for agroclimatic zone-wise planning, and I have already conducted several meetings. And this sea buckthorn has also been identified as one of the very high value crop which is required to be promoted. We used to say that for omega 3, I think we should go for sea buckthorn. And one of my colleague, when he saw your flyer in somewhere, he just told me, Dr. Malhotra, how you have become an expert of sea buckthorn? Then I mentioned him, I am not an expert, but we are jackal of all trades, but master of none. So here we are dealing with all crops. We need to see that how we can promote them, how we can have a kind of system in the country through which these such high value crops could be promoted. And then we need to see and align with our national agenda. Our national agenda is how we can reduce the import.